Am allowed loud and clear to everyone. If anyone is not getting my voice, kindly comment on chat box. Okay, today is my first lecture with you, and you have already seen me in board rotations and lectures. Okay, today the topic is hirsutism and viralization. I think we should start with the objective of hirsutism and viralization. What are our objectives today? We will be discussing about the definition of hirsutism, what is viralization, and what is hypertrichosis, and what is the difference in between all these, and what are the types of hairs, their growth cycle, what are the androgens in females, causes of high androgens, and what are the causes of hirsutism in female. What are causes of viralization, Ferriman-Galloway scoring, and the history, examination, investigation, and treatment. Because you will be dealing with the patients in OPD and clinics, and you should know how to take the history. And so we'll be starting with the definition of hirsutism. So what is hirsutism? It is a presence of excessive facial and body hair in women. Normally, females have body hairs, but this is the presence of excessive facial and body hairs in a female. What is the cause? Why it has happened? It is caused by increased systemic and local androgen, resulting in a male pattern hair growth. Like a female has a different pattern of hair growth, but she acquires a male pattern of hair growth distribution, like thick hair growth on the chin, upper lips, chest, upper and lower back. Upper lower abdomen and upper arms, thighs, and buttocks. See, these are the different sides where we can look for hirsutism in a female. What is the incidence? It affects 5 to 10% of the women of reproductive age group. It is more higher in African Mediterranean origin. Okay. If anyone is having confusion in the definition of hirsutism, they can message me on chat box. It's a simple definition, presence of excessive facial and body hair in a female. Causes, you should know, there's a systemic increase in androgen and local androgen, resulting in male pattern hair growth. We'll discuss what are the causes later on, but this is a crude definition. Okay, sorry. Now, this is a picture in which you can see a female with hirsutism. See, this is the chin area, and there's a excessive hair growth. There's a sideburns in which there is excessive hair growth. So this is a hirsute female. Okay, now coming on to viralization. What is viralization? It's a more severe condition, more severe form of hirsutism, you can say, but it is a combination of hirsutism and masculinity. It is a more severe condition of androgen excess in a female. It includes combination of hirsutism and masculinity. That is, what is masculinity? That is clitoromegaly. You will find clitoromegaly in these females, deepening of voice, balding, like male pattern of balding on scalp, male body habitus, including increased muscle mass, decreased breast size. So if a female is coming to you with excessive hair growth, you should also look for signs of masculinity in order to label her as a hirsute female or a virilized female. Okay. Now, coming on to next, what is hypertrichosis? Okay, hypertrichosis is a very rare condition, and it is androgen independent. We did hirsute, we did viralization. These are androgen dependent, but hypertrichosis is androgen independent. It is excessive growth of hair in non-sexual sites. It is caused by drugs like phenytoin, cyclosporine, glucocorticoids. In hypothyroidism, you can also see this hypertrichosis, anorexia nervosa, or it can be congenital. It is limited to normal pattern of distribution. Like normally, where the hair growth is present, there will be excessive growth of the hair. Okay. So this is hypertrichosis, and most important thing is it is androgen independent. Okay, you can see the female with hypertrichosis. You can see the her forehead having thick hairs, her eyebrows having thick hairs, her face having thick hairs. This is hypertrichosis. Okay, now coming on to you should know how many types of hairs are we having. One type is lanugo hairs. These are the body hairs seen in the fetus and newborn. Okay. Hypertrichosis, I already mentioned the causes are drugs, including phenytoin, glucocorticoids, and hypothyroidism, anorexia nervosa, or it can be congenital as well. Okay. Okay, now coming on to the types of hairs, there are three types of hairs. One is the lanugo hairs, which you can see in the fetus and a newborn baby. Other one is the vellus hair. These are the fine light pigmented hairs which covers the whole body. Then there comes the terminal hairs, in which these are thick pigmented hair present on the face, limbs, scalp, axilla, and pubic hairs. These are the thick hairs. And the terminal hairs are androgen dependent. Okay, they require androgen for their growth. Achha. And the thickness depend upon the genetic and racial factors. It's like if the family history of thick hairs, they will be more prone, the child will also have a thick hairs, or there's a racial factors as well. Okay, these are the three different types of hairs. Okay, now next we come on to the growth cycle of hair. How the hair grows. There are three stages. One is the anagen, catagen, and the telogen stages. I'm just doing this with you so that you should get an idea how the hair grows, what are the types of hairs. We are more on hirsute and viralization, but you should know how the hair grows, what is the cycle of the hair. And first is the anagen. This is a growth phase. Mitosis occur in the basal matrix where the hair grows. In this phase, hair grows. Say it. Second is the catagen, in which there is rapid involution phase. Hair growth ceases in this stage. Then is the telogen stage, which is with the resting stage. And after that, the hair falls. Okay, I should show you the cycle. This is the anagen growth phase, in which there is nourishment to the hair follicle, there is blood supply, root, and the hair grows in this stage. Then there is a catagen stage. This is a transition period, okay? And then in which hair growth ceases. This is you can see the root is separated from the blood supply, and then there is a telogen resting stage without nourishment. Hair follicle goes further up, ultimately the hair dies, and then again the anagen phase started. So these are the different cycles. Mostly anagen phase is the growth phase where the drugs act, where the androgen causes growth of the hair. Okay, now from where this androgen is coming in the females. So there are different types of androgen in females as well. There's testosterone, which is produced 25% from the ovaries and 25% from the adrenal gland in a female. Okay. Then testosterone in the ovary, from where it is producing? It is produced by the theca cells under the control of LH, luteinizing hormone, and insulin acting through insulinic growth factor 1. These causes the release of the testosterone from the theca cells. What? The LH and the insulin acting through insulinic growth factor 1. Then there's dihydrotestosterone, which is the free testosterone. This testosterone, which is coming from the ovaries, this is further metabolized at the level of the hair follicle to more active form, that is dihydrotestosterone, by the enzyme, as you know, 5-alpha reductase. Okay, then there is dihydroepiandrosterone sulfate or dihydroepiandrosterone, which is coming from the adrenal gland. The other is the androstenedione, which is coming from the ovaries and the adrenal gland. These are the different types of androgen in a female. If there's an excess of these androgen, you will see there will be hirsutism, there will be viralization. Clear up till now. If any confusion, you can ask me. Okay, now what are these androgen? How they are being carried in the blood circulation, and what is the active form of these androgen? So androgen is found in three forms in the female. 80% is bounded with the sex hormone binding globulin. You should know this. What is sex hormone binding globulin? It is the globulin which carries, it is the globulin, protein globulin. It carries hormones which are androgenic. So it is 80% bound with the sex hormone binding globulin. Okay. Then the other 19% is bounded with the albumin. And the active form, which is the free form, this is the active form, which is only 1%. If this increases from 1%, then it causes further increase in androgen in the body, in blood circulation, and it leads to hirsutism. Okay, next. What are the causes of increased androgen level? How androgen is increased in our in a female who is hirsute? So these are the different causes. One is the reduced sex hormone binding globulin. As we have already discussed that 80% is of androgen is bounded with the sex hormone binding globulin. So if the sex hormone binding globulin is reduced, then what will happen? The sex hormone binding globulin could not carry enough androgen, and the androgen will be in free form, and it will cause it will be the active form, and it will lead to hirsutism. So reduced sex hormone binding globulin level is a cause of androgen, increased androgen level, hyperandrogenism. And what are the causes of reduced sex hormone binding globulin? So hyperinsulinemia is one of the cause. When there is an increased insulin in the blood circulation, it causes decreased sex hormone binding globulin production from the liver. It is being produced in the liver. Okay. Second is a liver disease. If the liver is already diseased, then there will be limited production of sex hormone binding globulin. Other is the androgen. If all androgen level is already high, the sex hormone binding globulin could not carry enough androgen, and this will lead to increased androgen level. Further is the hyperprolactinemia and hypothyroidism. These also lead to decreased sex hormone binding globulin level. Okay, now next, what are the causes? Increased production. One is decreased sex hormone binding globulin. Other is androgen are being produced more. Sex hormone binding globulin is normal, but the androgen level is more. Its production is more. What are the causes? Why it is being produced more? One is the tumors. Tumors of the ovary and adrenal glands. These can lead to increased production of androgen. Other is the enzyme defects, like seen in congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Third is the Cushing syndrome. Then hyperinsulinemia, in which there is increased production of androgen level. Increased LH stimulate theca cells, and from these theca cells testosterone is being produced, so there will be increased production. Okay, next, exogenous androgen sources. If the person is of, if a female is taking androgen exogenously, like in a form of pills, in the form of drugs. Other is the progestogens with androgenic potential. There are certain progesterone supplements which have androgenic potential, like they are being producing androgens. So these are the exogenous sources. So in the history, when you are asking a hirsute female in the history, you should know that about the drug history as well, or any over-the-counter medication she is being taken. Other is increased 5-alpha-reductase sensitivity. What does 5-alpha-reductase causes? It causes conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone, which is the active form at the hair follicle level. So insulin like growth factor 1 causes its increased sensitivity. Okay, now coming on to the we did the causes of androgen, why androgen is being produced more. One is the decreased sex hormone binding globulin. Other, we did the increased production. Then we did exogenous sources and increased 5-alpha reductase sensitivity. Now, coming on to the main topic, which is the causes of hirsutism. What are the causes of hirsutism? If we are looking a female in our OPD, we should look think of all the causes of hirsutism. First cause is the ovary, because androgen are being produced in the ovaries. So the in females, polycystic ovarian syndrome is the 95% cause of hirsutism. Then coming on to the androgen secreting ovarian tumors, which is lead to less than 1% cause, but it is also a cause. Luteoma, which is a luteal cyst formation, which causes increased androgen productions. Then coming on to the adrenal gland. Adrenal gland also produces androgens. The causes will be congenital adrenal hyperplasia. Why congenital adrenal hyperplasia happen? Anyone? In congenital adrenal hyperplasia, there will be enzymatic defect, like 21, very good, like 21 hydroxylase deficiency, which lead to over, which lead to the cycle of cortisol formation is being inhibited, and the cycle turn towards the more production of androgens. Okay, good. This is also autosomal recessive inheritance. Okay, the other is the androgen secreting tumors. Then is the Cushing syndrome, and then acromegaly also causes adrenal gland overproduction of the androgen from the adrenal gland. Okay, these are ovarian causes, adrenal causes. Then causes of hirsutism also include external causes like iatrogenic hirsutism, being due to any drugs induced, like if the patient is being taken anabolic steroids, danazol, testosterone. These are the medications which also, these are androgenic, and these causes hirsutism. Okay, then there will be peripheral causes, idiopathic, which we don't know. The other is the insulin resistance. There's a syndrome called Hyrand syndrome, in which there is hyperandrogenic insulin resistant acanthosis nigricans. Okay, what happens in this? This is a combination of hirsutism. This Hyrand syndrome is a combination of hirsutism, acanthosis nigricans, and insulin resistance. This is a hereditary condition due to insulin receptor defect, and it is associated with severe hirsutism. Okay. Next, we coming on to the causes of viralization. How viralization is being caused? We discussed why, what is viralization? It is a combination of hirsutism and masculinity. Okay. Yeah, and it is a more severe form. Okay. The causes of hirsutism is congenital adrenal hyperplasia. As we already discussed, it is due to deficiency of 21 hydroxylase deficiency. There is a block in the production of 11 deoxycortisol from 17 hydroxyprogesterone. Okay, then there is an iatrogenic cause, that is androgen therapy. If an androgen therapy like danazol is being given to treat endometriosis, this is a ovarian condition in which there is a formation of hemorrhagic cysts. So if the patient is being given danazol, which is an androgen, it can lead to viralization. Okay. The other causes will be ovarian tumors like adenoblastoma, granulosa cell tumors, that can lead to viralization. There will be Cushing syndrome, which can also lead to viralization. Okay. Now you see the mechanism. What is the mechanism of increase hair growth? Okay, this stimulus of excessive hair growth is testosterone. Testosterone is the stimulus which causes increased hair growth. So what happens? Testosterone first go and bind to the androgen receptor in the hair follicle. It causes activation of 5 alpha reductase and convert testosterone to dihydrotestosterone and androstenediol. This stimulate proliferation and growth of the terminal hair, and thus lead to hirsutism. If there is more testosterone, there will be more conversion into DHT, and there will be more terminal hair formation leading to hirsutism. Is it clear? From testosterone is coming from where? It is coming from the ovary. And the adrenal androgen also producing androgens, which are ultimately converting into testosterone. Okay, now what will the be the history? How will you take the history from these patients? First, if a female is coming, I already told you about the types of hair, terminal hair. We did three types of hair, na? Term, there will be lanugo hairs in the fetus, then is the vellus hair, then is the terminal hair. Terminal hair is the thick hairs which are present in the adult. Okay. What are the history points? If a patient is coming to you in the OPD, first you will ask about the age, marital status. You will ask about the rate of onset of symptoms. Either they are acute in onset or they are slow, and the severity and duration. Then you will ask about the menstrual cycle. Either she has the disturbed menstrual cycle, there's oligomenorrhea, amenorrhea, you are looking for PCOS. There you should ask about the genetic factors like diabetes mellitus or any enzyme deficiency or history of PCO in the family like sisters and mothers. Then you will ask about the drug history like oral contraceptive pills with androgenic effect, any drug she is being using or any drug abuse she is being having, or and general health and other symptoms like Cushing syndrome, acromegaly, liver disease. You will ask about that. History of infertility you will be asking from the patient if she is married and she has not conceived yet. Okay, now coming on to the physical examination, what will be you looking for? In general examination, you will be looking for acne, signs of viralization. What are the signs of viralization we did previously? Can anybody tell me? Signs of viralization are the clitoromegaly, okay, deepening of voice, balding, male body appearance like increase muscle mass, breast size decrease. Yes, right. Clitoromegaly, you will look for clitoromegaly, and you will also look for the voice changes, the balding, scalp balding like male pattern, and in muscle mass of the female and the breast size. Then you will be looking for acanthosis nigricans. What is acanthosis nigricans? It is a gray velvety skin appearance in the neck, axilla and groin. We'll see. This is the acanthosis nigricans. It appears in the neck. This is a blackening of the skin. This is acanthosis nigricans. And this usually happens due to insulin resistance. Mostly you have seen this in obese patient or in polycystic ovarian syndrome patients. Okay, then if the patient is already hirsute and you are seeing, then you have to score that hirsutism. Like there's a scoring system named Ferriman-Galway scoring system in which we look for 9 body parts. These are the 9 different areas where will we see the growth of the hair. First is the upper lip, then the chin, chest, arm, upper abdomen, lower abdomen, upper back, lower back and thighs. These are the 9 areas where you have to look for the growth of the hair. Okay, this each part body area score from 0 to 4. 0 means no hair and the 4 is the thick hair growth. Minimum score is 8 if you label a patient hirsute. Okay. Now, next, I'll show you the picture. These are the different areas of the body. This is the upper lip, where this is a 1, you give it 1. Then if there's a less hair, less prominent hair growth, then it is a mild form, moderate, and then the severe form is a thick terminal hair growth. Normally, these are not so thick. Then coming on to the chin area, you'll see there's a beard like appearance in this female. Then the chest area, normally female doesn't have thick hairs in the terminal hairs in these areas, but this is a male pattern of hair growth. Okay, then the abdomen, lower abdomen, okay, then the arms, then the thighs, back, lower back, upper back and lower back. So these are the different areas you will be looking for, and you will be scoring this. So this is a Ferryman-Galway scoring system. You will be scoring according to the severity of hirsutism. Okay. Now, next. Then you will be doing the pelvic examination, looking for any pelvic mass, clitoromegaly. You will to look for if this is a only a hirsutism or the viralization. Okay, next, this is your physical examination. Now further, what will you do? You will investigate the patient. Say, how will you investigate? You will go for serum testosterone. If this is more than 5, it will suggest there is an androgen producing tumor, because testosterone measures the ovarian and adrenal activity. Then there will be dihydroepiandrosterone sulfate concentration. This suggests androgen adrenal causes, and it measures the adrenal activity. Then if you want to screen, if you are suspecting congenital adrenal hyperplasia, you will screen by doing 17 hydroxyprogesterone levels. Then if there is insulin resistance and there is a history, family history of diabetes, there's a you suspect PCOS in the patient, you go for oral glucose tolerance test. The other test for Cushing syndrome are dexamethasone suppression test and 24-hour urine for cortisol level. And the other is pelvic imaging, in which we will be doing transvaginal scan in a married, and in unmarried we'll do go for ultrasound pelvis to look for polycystic ovaries or ovarian tumor. In case of tumor, we'll further do advanced imaging like CT scan, MRI. Okay, these are the investigations. Okay, now coming on to the treatment. How will you treat a hirsute patient? First is the lifestyle modification. Lifestyle changes including the weight reduction. If the patient is having PCOS, you will advise her regarding the dietary changes. You will advise her for weight reduction. Then there are topical methods. How to, if the hair are already grown, how to remove them, like by bleaching, plucking, shaving, waxing. These are topical methods. If the patient is tired of these topical methods, instead of a permanent cure, you can go for laser and electrolysis. The other method, which are systemic anti-androgenic therapies, mainly the treatment aimed towards the underlying cause. If there are PCOS, we'll treat PCOS. If there's a Cushing syndrome, we'll treat to Cushing syndrome. But so the treatment aim is towards the underlying cause. You have to find out the cause, as we have already done the causes of hirsutism. So we'll go for, we are in history and in our investigation, we'll rule out the cause and we'll treat that cause. And overall, to relieve the symptoms of hirsutism, we'll go for systemic anti-androgenic therapies. Okay, like combined oral contraceptive pills in containing ethinyl estradiol and ciproterone acetate. Ciproterone acetate has a feature of it is an anti-androgen. It causes increased clearance of testosterone, and it binds to, ciproterone acetate binds to the androgen receptors, and it reduces the activity of 5-alpha reductase. It comes with the name of DIN-35 usually. Okay, ciproterone acetate is a potent progestogen, and it is given along with the estrogen. Why? In order to maintain regular menstruation and to prevent conception, and it also causes, estradiol also causes increased sex hormone binding globulin. So we give it in a combination. Okay, then spironolactone. Spironolactone, as you already know, it is an aldosterone antagonist. It also inhibits adrenal and ovarian androgens, and it competitively binds with androgen receptors, and it also inhibits 5-alpha reductase. And it action is slower, much slower. It takes 6 months to have a full action on hirsutism. Finasteride is in 5 milligram dose. It inhibits 5-alpha reductase activity. Okay. Now, other drugs, what are the other medications? This flutamide, this is also anti-androgen. Its best effects is seen after 6 months of treatment. Then Eflornithine hydrochloride, this is a topical cream which causes ornithine decarboxylase inhibition, and it which is responsible for hair growth. And this topical cream works in 8 weeks. Okay, then GnRH agonist, this suppresses gonadotropins and thereby suppressing the ovarian androgens. Okay, then in the end there is surgical treatment. If there is Cushing's syndrome, you will go for hypophysectomy. If there is adrenal and ovarian tumor, then you will go for surgical removal of those. So there is a surgical option as well. Okay, now we have completed the topic of hirsutism viralization. If you have any question or any confusion, you can ask me. Or if you want me to repeat anything, you can ask me. Okay, one of you have asked me why can't viralization be caused by PCOS, since that also leads to androgen excess. Okay, see, what is polycystic ovary syndrome? Can anybody? In polycystic ovarian syndrome, what happens? There is an ovulation, there is unruptured follicle in which there is increased LH, which causes increased androgen production, okay, which leads to hirsutism and acne and weight gain. And there is insulin resistance, which causes decrease in sex hormone binding globulin. When sex hormone binding globulin is reduced, there will be active form of androgen available, and there will be excess androgen. So these patients lead to hirsutism. While in viralization, what happens? There will be hirsutism, but there will be also masculinity, which is not seen in polycystic ovary syndrome. Okay, there will be no clitoromegaly, no deepening of voice. Androgen will not be acting on these parts. Okay, what is hypophysectomy? It is the removal of the tumor from the pituitary, like in Cushing syndrome. Viralization, you label viralization if you find hirsutism as by scoring it through Ferriman-Galway scoring, as well as you find the masculinity symptoms like clitoromegaly, deepening of the voice. You will ask about from the patient regarding the voice changes, regarding the hair fall like male pattern balding, and the decrease in breast size. And you will examine as well, like you will examine the breast size, you will examine the clitoromegaly if present, you will examine there's alopecia on the scalp. So you will label as viralization. Okay, in investigation, see, we did the causes of hirsutism. Okay, I will go on the causes of hirsutism. I mentioned the limited investigations, but these are the causes of hirsutism. Now, if you are finding any significant cause, like if you are finding like symptoms of Cushing syndrome, and the patient body apparatus is also like that. There's a body hump, increased abdominal circumference, and you find this Cushing syndrome symptoms. So you will investigate for that by cortisol levels, dexamethasone suppression test. If you find there is a pelvic mass, you suspect there is an excessive hair growth, and in a short period of time, you are suspecting for an ovarian tumors. So you will investigate it by pelvic imaging. You will further investigate by CT scan. Okay, like if you are suspecting signs of hyperinsulinism, like increased insulin levels, you will go for OGTT. Okay. In investigation, I mentioned the limited investigation, but if you are finding any cause in related to these conditions, like polycystic ovaries or congenital adrenal hyperplasia, in which you go for 17-hydroxyprogesterone levels, so you'll go for those in specific investigation. You don't order for all the investigations. Okay. Okay, what is the score we label? Okay, viralization ho gaya. Narrowed and vasectomy. Thank you. Okay. Most important for you are the causes as well as the definition of hirsutism. Okay. You should know the cause, androgen level, how androgen level is increased, what are the causes of increased androgen level. What is viralization? So this is a combination of hirsutism and masculinity. You see the symptoms. Okay. Hypertrichosis is a rare condition, but you should know it is androgen independent. And there's excessive hair growth on non-sexual sites caused by drugs, hypothyroidism, anorexia, congenital, and it is limited to normal pattern of hair distribution like this. See the forehead of the female. Okay, these are the type of hair. Someone was asking me what is terminal hair. So these are thick pigmented hair which are present on the face, limbs, scalp, axilla, pubic hair. Okay. And these are androgen dependent. So if the androgen level is high, these terminal hair will be more thicker, more denser. Okay. This is just to tell you how the hair growth happens. And normally the drugs act in the anagen phase of the cell cycle, not in these two stages. So that's why whenever we are dealing with systemic anti-androgens, we have to give it for prolonged period because the hair cycle takes a long time. So it takes 6 months as well to start treating hirsutism. If the patient is taking medication and she has just been given for a month and she's not seeing any difference, so we'll reassure her that it will take 6 months at least. The hypothyroidism is causing decreased sex hormone binding globulin. Okay, when sex hormone binding globulin is reduce, there will be increase in free androgen level. We are not giving flutamide after 6 months. We are giving it for 6 months. After being given 6 months, it will start showing results. Okay, this is important. Androgen, what are the forms, and the 80% bound to sex hormone binding globulin, 19% is bound to the albumin. These are the inactive forms. Only 1% is the active form. If the free form is more than 1%, there will be hyperandrogenism. Okay, these are the causes. You see, hyperthyroidism causes decreased sex hormone binding globulin. Hyperprolactinemia also causes decreased sex hormone. So these leads to increased androgen levels. Okay, you can see this. Exogenous sources are also important. You should ask the drug history as well. Okay, these are the causes, yeah, ovarian cause, adrenal cause. You should focus on the ovary and adrenal first. Then you should go for exogenous cause, any external cause, or any peripheral cause which is leading to hirsutism. These are the simple. You should first make a mind from where androgen is coming. It is coming from the ovary and adrenal gland. So you should first think the causes in the ovary and adrenal gland. What causes hirsutism? What causes increased androgen level? So you in history as well, you should focus on these two. Then on the external causes like drug history, and then the peripheral causes, which is idiopathic, or this is a rare condition. There's a syndrome which is due to insulin receptor deficiency. Okay, viralization causes are these. Okay. History. These are the limited points in history. You should further elaborate according to the history the patient is giving. Okay. We did this. This is an important Ferriman Galvez scoring. You should know from where you will look for, you will be looking for the hirsutism. Okay, minimum score is 8 to diagnose hirsutism. Each part is being given a score of 1 to 4. These are the investigations, but these are being not all investigations are being sent. You should be focusing on after taking the history, what is your differentials, and according to those differential, you will be sending the investigations. Okay, then these are the temporary permanent methods, then systemic anti androgens. Okay, what is the score slide? Which score slide? This? Okay. This one, I think the time is up now. If you have any confusion, you can come and ask me as well. I'll be there in gynae also department.